Follow all Moessieurs news on his website, www.moessieurs.com, and on his Facebook page.
Hello and welcome to Moessieurs for this new video about Camelot Pro version 2.1. And today the topic is about FX, but virtual FX, and not for your virtual instrument, for your synth. So see fully the video, you will see it's interesting. And I let you with Grace and Paul.
I show you what we have on Camelot Pro screen. There are quite a few things. Here, Joel is with his MODX. It will work in same way with any synthesizer that has an assignable USB audio bus management, with possibility to have separate audio inputs and separate audio outputs. Obviously, if your synthesizer doesn't have audio through USB, it won't work. MODX have 5 stereo outputs buses, so it will be 5 stereo audio inputs in Camelot Pro. We can also manage mono if you want, of course, with MODX or another keyboard that manages mono USB audio buses, you manage them too. Joel choose a MODX lead sound, and here is a little difference since the beginning of its videos for audio layers. On MIDI layers, Joel show you little circles activity that blink when he play on keyboard. It show MIDI activity. For audio layers that are audio in, you will see this little arrows. Unlike MIDI, you don't have any blinking for audio that goes in there.
Joel set its MODX audio input on layer. For items, he select a small Yamaha guitar effect. Like you can see, we can take every VST effect settings in hand with mouse on computer or finger on iPad. There is also an audio send as item, we will explain this later. On Setlist rack there is a Yamaha ReverbX that Joel use with a plate preset cause he like to use plate FX. There is also an Arturia chorus. So how does it all work? Grace will start to explain it. Let's just switch to the wide view, here it is.
Yes, Paul, I will explain some things that are important to understand. On MODX, Joel have cut insert FX, a tempo phaser and a cross delay. Of course he could let them in addition to effects that are in Camelot Pro. But for this video, to avoid you to think which effect is well heard, internal FX or VST FX, Joel set them off. How does Joel set its MODX output instead of having it as a main output? On MODX you go here to part output, and instead of setting main LNR, we chose a stereo USB output bus, the 1 and 2 for this example. Of course Joel have set this MODX output as audio input bus in Camelot Pro settings. So this MODX output that goes through USB into Camelot Pro, benefit now VST effects.
Yes Grace, which is important to understand then for MODX, and it will be certainly the same on another synthesizer, is that you obviously, you need to turn on USB volume return on your synthesizer. Otherwise it doesn't work. Of course, it depends how it's managed on your synthesizer. As example on MODX, you have to manage your USB volume monitor here with this knob, to manage effect send quantity coming from Camelot Pro. If I let it to zero, there will not be effect return. You have to set the USB return level from Camelot to hear VST effects, and set a good value to hear it. Enough but not too much of course. I think there is a parallel on various synthesizer that manage assignable USB audio output, to compare to Montage, there is not a specific knob, it's on a dedicated screen for each performance.
Let's choose now this view, so you can see everything. You have to go to Camelot Pro settings. In audio settings, you have to configure your audio output. In general way, to see all audio buses, you need to choose ASIO. For main audio out, Joel let MODX main LNR. For input you see, we can rename buses. Here you see we have all stereo buses, and Joel set 1 and 2 as first entry. You can also switch to mono by clicking here. Let's configure one other. Here you have mono example, let's switching to stereo, set 3 and 4 and if we need we can activate it. Let's come back to layer view. As remember, Joel assigned audio bus with crunch effect which is in song rack, so why is it in song rack? Because for whole song, Joel wanted to have this effect. But, why there is two effects in setlist rack here?
We have already explained scenes and songs on others' videos. Here it's a very good example to explain setlist rack choice. First of all, when you switch to USB 1 and 2 on MODX, and it can be the same case on other synthesizers, you don't have system effects anymore. For MODX it's mean that you will not have for this sound or part, reverb, variation, master EQ and master FX effects. We use independent audio bus that keep the two insert effects, and you need to remember that we have set them off for this video. In this example, Joel need to replace internal MODX reverb and variation effect by VST FX. But why I put them in the setlist rack and not in song layer? Because if on each song, we let all VST or Auv3 FX on song layer, you need to load all of them for each song, it's take a little bit of time. Putting system FX like reverb or chorus which are general FX in the setlist rack, allow us to load once only when you select your setlist, and you don't have to load them again.
But how do we handle sending audio from song layer to setlist rack? It's this item, audio send with a volume send or send FX. So this is what we send from song layer to setlist rack FX. You can manage them individually if you want. Create two layers in setlist rack, one for reverb, one for chorus, and use two audio send items to route them to each effect. But here, to make it simple for this video, Joel didn't go that far. Of course you could also put your audio send items to scene rack, to mute them, manage send FX, you have a lot of flexibility and it's a great new Camelot Pro feature. I encourage you to try it, you will see, it's not complicated, as long as there are audio assignable buses that can be assigned on your synthesizer. So, it goes from USB from your synthesizer into your computer or iPad, pass through VST effect you set in place on Camelot Pro, and comes back on the other side through USB main out, that's why you have to manage return volume effect.
I hope you have find this video interesting. If yes, please click on the thumb. It's important for me to know that you like the content of this video. And if you are not already a Moessieurs follower, click on subscribe and click on bell to be informed when a new video is released. And see you soon for the next Moessieurs video.
Join Camelot Pro community. Follow our Camelot Pro online sessions, organized by audio modeling, available in English, French, German, and Italian.
Sessions are conducted in groups, online through Zoom. Make Camelot Pro your ideal and essential stage partner.
E-learning online English courses are led by Gerald Peter.
Les masterclass en ligne et en français sont animés par Joël Borg.
E-learning online Deutschkurse werden geleitet von Gerald Peter.
Online e-learning corsi italiano sono tenuti con Fabio Nuti.